It's great. It's great human drama. I mean, you're talking about crime and punishment at the highest level. You're talking about, what right does society as a general entity have to take away someone's freedom? Well, that lends itself to a lot of other questions. Who are the people who commit serious crimes? What are they like? They tend to be pretty fascinating, believe it or not. And so I find the work fascinating. And yeah, it happens to be, let's call it, a fertile soil for novels or fiction, if done right.
Is it fair to compare your book to An Executioner's Song?
Well, he showed you the humanity of somebody who you are, on a surface level, you would say is inhuman, right? So yeah, there's some. I mean, I think that's a good comparison in the sense of what's happening. Part of what's happening, let's say, in A Naked Singularity is, there haven't been too many depictions of the people who are in jail right now. There haven't, in the United States, there's about 2.3 million people incarcerated at any given moment. That's a lot of people. They can't all be monsters, right? So I think that it lends itself to what a novelist's job. Now, I understand Executioner's Song is not strictly a novel, but it lends itself to the novelist's job, which is to see inside of the people, no matter what the external attributes are, to see something deeper. That's kind of the responsibility of the fiction writer.
Where did the book's characters come from?
I try to avoid archetypes. I try to avoid kind of, this character represents blank, this character. What you try, certainly with something like A Naked Singularity, that's a long book, the primary character, the narrator, should be a compelling voice. God willing, it's going to bring you through 800 pages or so. With respect to other characters, sometimes, they are brief snippets of them, but you try to somehow find the humanity in it in as quickly a way as you can. So I think that no, they're not necessarily a one-to-one correspondence between somebody you know and somebody you don't, but they are necessary inventions that are being driven by the overall aesthetic of the novel, what the novel's trying to create, not achieve, create. What's trying the dream world you're trying to create required these 5, 6, 10 people, and so you try to build them.
Do you do a lot of editing?
For that book, I mean, I'm not into a lot of drafts, and I'm certainly not all that interested in an external input when I'm writing. So there wasn't much of that. What I thought was is important to do is if X is going to happen, then the challenge for the writer is to filter X through this invented consciousness, right? So it's not just, when you're talking about a first-person narration, you can't really just depict and then X happened. It's X happened as seen by this consciousness, right? So you better have a strong idea of what the consciousness is like so that you can, in essence, guess at what their reaction would be to certain events.